In this video, I'm talking to Daniela Bolzmann from Mindful Goods about how to optimize Amazon product listings to make them launch ready. Daniela will share the number one mistake Amazon sellers usually do when they optimize their product listings, teaches how to do it better, and also gives away a three-step guide how to make listings which will convert shoppers to buyers. To learn more about Mindful Goods and their services, click on the link in the description. And if you like this conversation, then definitely don't forget to like this video and also subscribe to Orange Klik YouTube channel. Hi, Daniela. I'm really happy to have you here on Orange Klik channel today. We will talk about product listing optimization. But before we do that, could you please introduce yourself and tell us what you do in the Amazon space?
Sure. Thanks for having me. My name is Daniela Bolzmann. I'm the founder of Mindful Goods. This is Chanchito. He's joining us for the presentation today. But we optimize Amazon listings day in and day out with a team of creatives located all over the world. We've been doing it about 5 years now, and we've become kind of the go-to shop for listing optimization.
Okay, sounds really good. And because you have tons of experience in optimizing listings, then today you will cover a couple of things that are really important for all Amazon sellers, no matter if they're just starting out or they're already like older sellers adding just new products, because I think it's always good to go over some fundamental things and also perhaps get a new tip how to optimize the product listings even better.
Exactly. We're going to break down our three-step process that we've honed in on after working on hundreds of Amazon listings over time, but we're going to make it very simple with some golden nuggets for the beginners and some golden nuggets for the people who are more advanced.
Perfect. Sounds really good. So yeah, go ahead, share your screen and let's go.
Okay, let's get into it. A little bit about us. We're a one-stop shop for Amazon listings done better. Our team is located all over the world across 7 countries. And over the last few years, we have optimized hundreds of product listings on Amazon. We've also been featured by Amazon themselves in a case study. And just to show you some of our typical clients, we service very early stage brands and VC-backed brands. So from really small brands to really big brands. This is Ingrid. We took her from $35,000 a month in sales to $125,000 a month in sales within a few months. This is Anne. She started net new to Amazon, meaning she had never been on Amazon before, and she was tripling her sales out the gate without any advertising. And this is the Uni Sisters. They actually bootstrapped their product. They did not have outside funding when they wanted to validate their product. They used Amazon and they saw a tremendous response. So they have kind of a really unique case study as well with us. And this is a more established brand that you might know. It might be in your cabinets right now, Pop Chips. We help them double their conversion rates across their catalog. And what we're going to do today is actually break this down. But the one thing I wanted to share across all these clients is what they have in common. They have scroll stopping content. And so this is actually a message from one of the reps that we work with at Amazon that basically said these three things on a phone call that we had with him. He said, 99% of brands need better content. Great content should make their money back almost immediately. And good content isn't good enough, right? So these are the really basic things that I like to explain when you're first getting started, or even when you're an established brand on Amazon. You want to be rethinking the fundamentals of your content and your traffic, right? If your traffic's not working for you, you need to go back to your content. If your conversion rates are not working, that's where you start. And then you go back to turning on traffic, right? So why does this matter? This is the data that we have. Amazon is reporting that A+ content alone is lifting sales across the board of 5%. That's including the brands that are not doing this well. That's across the board, right? So we've seen way higher lists than that. Going to from zero A+ content to having A+ content can see uplifts of 72 to 210% uplift in conversion rates. And that study was actually done by DataHawk across thousands of different brands. And then the other thing that's really important to remember here, and this is probably the biggest one for me, is that 90% of what is taken in as a shopper, 90% is communicated to your brain through visuals, right? So the visuals can seem like it's an added expense. It can seem like you don't want to spend the money to do this, but that is what sells. Great packaging sells. Great images sell. So this is the thing that's really important to get right. So the three things we're going to cover today is the biggest mistake that I see across the board with most brands, the anatomy of an Amazon optimization so that you can really understand the three steps in this. And then we're going to break down those three steps. So the one thing that I see most often, the most critical thing I see, is that there was a quick and dirty setup, right? So you want to get selling really fast. You go to your Dropbox, you upload a bunch of images, and then you just never go back to fix it, right? Even when the cash is rolling in, you still want to go back and look and see what else you can fix now that you're up and running, right? So we see this now, especially with a lot of brands who got in early on Amazon, then they see their competitors entering the marketplace. And now they're like, oh gosh, we need to go back and make sure we step up our game because now our competitors are stealing our market share, right? So these are the things you want to be thinking about early on. And even if you're an established seller. So the other thing that's really important to understand here is that Amazon is a search engine first. If your product's pages are not optimized, then people are not going to be able to find you. And you can have the greatest product in the world, but if people can't find you, you're just going to be losing money and wasting your ad spend. So the solution is a funnel. And I want to make this really simple for people because it can get lost in the details here. But a funnel is just a fancy way of saying the journey that your customers take. Right? So it's also called an optimization funnel, a conversion funnel, a sales funnel. It's the same thing, but it's a series of steps that your shopper takes. And in each step, people drop off in the process. And each step can be optimized so that you can get more sales and more people to that final destination. So to show you what this looks like, people search in the search box on Amazon, they see the results, they click, they get to the page, and they buy. To see this as a funnel, they search. So let's say 20,000 people are searching for this specific phrase. Only 4% of them are going to make it to the next page to see your product page. And then maybe only 10% of those are going to buy, right? So this is the way that we want to think about optimizing each step for searching, for clicking, and for buying. It's going to look like this: search, click, buy. So what do we need to do with search, click, buy? We need to get found. We need to get clicks. And we need to get sales. It's as simple as that. Those are the three goals that we need to be thinking about. So the way that we break down the goals is we're going to have SEO to get found. We're going to have eye-catching main images to get those clicks. And then once they get into our product listing, we are going to blow them away with compelling content. So let's show you exactly how we do that. So the first step is getting found. And the one thing that we want to ask you here is, have you included the most relevant keywords that people might be using to discover your product? So what we need to think about with SEO is angles and routes. And so we want to take yourself outside of just you searching for the product and think of your customers and anyone who might be using this product to solve a problem or gift it or whatever the use cases may be. Those are your angles. The root of your product might be that it's a journal, but if you look at this example, it's a great visual example to show you. Could your journal be for women, girls, teenage girls? Those are all great, relevant search terms for your product. Let's say it's a pink one, or, you know, for whatever reason, you are saying that this one is more specific for girls. Maybe it's about fairy tales and that kind of design, right? Maybe it's a leather-bound black one that you'd consider more for business, or it has lines, or for boys or men, or whatever. You want to be thinking of all the different angles around your product. And that's where you want to go with SEO. The reason why this matters again is because this is what's going to help you show up for more searches. I'm actually going to break down a title test that we did with a very small client to show you how even the tiniest changes for your SEO in your title can have a big impact. The other thing to remember here is that it's not just about the SEO, your price, your reviews, are you using FBA, all of those things matter. But the thing you can control is the relevant keywords that you're using in the front end and back end of your listing. The other thing you want to be thinking about very specifically is the purchase behavior in relation to your relevant searches, right? So are you selling well in relation to your competitors? If not, that's when you're going to want to turn on some traffic and start targeting some specific keywords to see what are people shopping for? Because you can take that data from your ads reports and then infuse that back into your listing, right? So again, 80% of this can be done upfront with the optimization process. You can use tools to actually figure out these keywords that are going to work best for you, but you want to then also pull the data from your keyword reports later from your advertising and optimize again. So some of the tools that we use for this, we love using WordTree to do a quick reverse ASIN. You can also do that in Helium 10. Data Dive has been great if you want to try to figure out the strongest ways to build your listing titles, for instance. And really the key takeaway here is to spend a significant amount of time, because this is step one. Each one of these steps can have a huge impact on your bottom line. So the second step is main images. And this one, I think, is what I like to say is the lowest hanging fruit that every brand should be doing that most brands are not doing. And this is something we take super seriously. That's why we make this our own step in our process for every project that we work on with every client. The things that you want to consider here are white space, what we call eye candy, photos versus renders, packaging, and split testing. So let's get into this. The question you want to ask yourself here is, when you go search for your product on Amazon and your product shows up in all the search results, is this where I belong? And is my offer competitive in this area, right? Because we've gotten the SEO, we're showing up in search. Is this where I need to be? If yes to both of those questions, now how do I stand out so that people click on mine instead of all these competitors, right? So one example of white space. If you have your designer create, you know, just a product on white image for you, by the way, this is super bland. I wouldn't upload something like this to Amazon, but let's just say you did. You would want to remove the white space, because what's going to happen is your product is going to look smaller than the other product. So just removing the white space, look how much bigger this looks. This is something so basic, but so many brands miss this one little tiny thing. So that's why I like to call it out. The other thing is eye candy, right? This is things like positioning, use of space, call outs, colors. Some of these things are not allowed anymore on Amazon. People started doing this when they saw brands where it was working for brands on Walmart. So like having post edits outside of your packaging, you can't do anymore. Your listing will get flagged. But look at how like a slight angle or showing the variety packs, like one a little bit larger on top of the other ones, or over here kind of doing like a fan out of the product. Like these are very eye-catching. And then when we talk about white space, look at how much white space here and how much smaller this product looks, right? And then look at this, it's just like a single bag. So it's just kind of boring and left out, right? But if you had a close-up of this snack and maybe it was coming off to the side, then maybe it would trick your eye to kind of be like, ooh, what's that? You know, so you can see all of these brands here are doing a really good job with their packaging, but also the orientation of how everything is spaced to try to trick your eyes to come over here, come over here. It's eye candy, it's enticing, right? So that's the way you wanna be thinking about these main images. The other thing is looking at photos versus renders. So Amazon doesn't like renders because oftentimes brands do renders poorly, right? But if you do a great quality render, it can actually help you improve your click-through rate tremendously. We're gonna show you an example of that. But first I wanted to show you a photo. This is a high res photo, but you can see how it looks washed out. This brand actually had a new label made so that it would be more clear. And we were able to create a render of the product at such an angle that you actually can't even achieve with a photo, right? And what this does is it actually aids the shopper in their experience, because now they can actually read that it says rose gold on there. They can read the name of the brand. They can read the packaging really easily. And then here's a little bit of eye candy thrown in there. This kind of stuff is stuff that you want to test though, to understand, is this something that your target demographic would gravitate towards, for your specific product, right? In our testing, what we realized with something like this is that, minimalism works best for a certain age demographic, whereas the eye candy sometimes can work better for, a younger demographic who is more enticed by smells, right? So, by seeing the different flavors. So those are some things that you do want to test in advance before you're uploading to Amazon. Another example of how packaging can make it pop is with pop chips, right? You have like a simple basic bag. And this is a client that we've worked with actually twice. They came back to us and we did this kind of a main image where you're really visually showing the flavor in a bold way, right? And you have this little close-up, actually it's a big close-up of the actual chip, so that customers can see like, oh yeah, that's the big crunchy thing that I wanted, you know? And it's really enticing. And they redid their packaging. And then you have what we call a post edit right here, which is just to show people that they're gonna be buying a 4-pack, right? And they can see that from the search results. So that if they were wondering, oh, is this a 10 pack, a 12 pack, a 40 pack? It's right there for you, really simply, right? So they click on that one because that's the specific one that they're looking for. Then the other thing I want to explain is there's two types of testing that we do, right? There's testing on something like PickZoom, which is using data that's off of Amazon. You can still target Amazon Prime shoppers. You get really fast data, probably less than an hour. It's very cost effective, but we use that data more so for iteration on our designs. We also use it for quantitative and qualitative data, right? So we're getting people that are using, that are explaining why they prefer one image over the other, and they're able to give us tangible qualitative details that we can see patterns within that language and then improve the image, right? So maybe they're all asking, is this product vegan? I can't see it on the packaging. Well, we should add a post edit so that people know it's vegan, you know, and then people see that from the search results. The second type of testing is Amazon experiments. And the downside to this is that Amazon experiments are slow. Amazon is recommending 8 to 10 weeks, and therefore we recommend 8 to 10 weeks. But it's one of those things where you can set it and forget it and come back and then run another test later and always keep these tests running and know that you're always optimizing your listing. So very highly recommend these tests. The other thing I love about these tests, there's three types. You can test your titles, your main images, and your A+ content. But my favorite piece about this is the projections. Amazon is actually gonna tell you with concrete data that this image is better than this image by X percent. It's improving your conversion rate by this percent. You've already gotten this amount of sales. And we anticipate that you're gonna see from X amount of sales to X amount of sales until, you know, for the next year because of this one image change. And so I'm going to show you an example of this in just a moment. Let's break down a split test that we do with something like PickFu so you can see the difference, right? We will ideate, we'll be in ideation mode thinking, okay, what's something that can get the clicks? Here's three different versions where we have this outer case, which does not exist, right? We just digitally made this, but now we have real estate to be putting a post edit that explains exactly what the shopper is looking for. They want 100% cold filtered coconut water without all the nasties. Right? So if we can say it on the packaging, we have a higher likelihood that people are going to click on our product over the other one. We also have a little bit of eye candy here. We have some splashes of the water behind. We have, you know, three different versions so that we can see which one is performing best, right? We get the quick data. We make any changes we need to make, maybe run another test, maybe not, depending on what the data says, right? So that's a PickFu test. But to show you how important this is, again, not a set and forget process. You can do this even if you're already launched. You should be doing this maybe, you know, 2-3 times to see what else you could be doing to improving your main images. An example of this is YesBar. They were already an established seller, already selling well in their category, decided that they wanted to refresh so they could stay competitive ahead of the curve. And within 2 weeks, they saw an 11.8% increase in their click-through traffic. I'm going to show you their test. This was their original image on the right. Notice white space. Notice how much smaller this looks. And their product actually was selling well, but looks so much smaller than all the other ones in the search box, in the search results, right? So the idea that we had was, well, what happens if we pull out the individual packs that are inside the box and we just kind of fan them out? And then we should put like it's 6 bars. So they understand that it's 6. And then we have a close-up, a bigger close-up of the bars. And then we'll take the original image that they already had, we'll digitally enhance it so that you can see it much more clearly. Let's make sure all of the edits on the packaging are legible, especially the word vegan, because we know that a lot of vegans love this product. That's our target demo. And then we want to make sure that we have a post edit explaining from the search results that we have 6 bars. This 6 bars is not on their actual packaging. We are aiding the shopper in their buying experience because we want them to understand from the search results how many bars so that they can just click and buy, right? And then we have a bigger pack. Notice we still have shadowing, we still have an angle. It's almost the same thing, but what we're trying to do is make the box fill out the entire frame and make everything as big and vibrant as possible. And most importantly, make it really easy for the shopper. We're aiding them in their experience. So that's the thing that Amazon cares about the most is, are you trying to take advantage of the shopper? Are you trying to manipulate the shopper? Or are you trying to make the buying experience better for them, right? So that's the things you need to be thinking about. People get scared to edit their images. It's not about tricking the shopper into buying. It's about helping them buy the thing that they want to buy, right? So this is the image that ended up winning. This is the image that ended up getting an increase in click-through traffic. And this is the way you need to be thinking about doing your main images. Now, let's talk about Amazon experiments, because since working on that project, we have actually had a chance to do some experiments with brands. And this is something that for the last year, we have been asking brands to do. And we are now helping brands do this because they're just not taking it into their own account and doing it on their own, right? But this is the kind of data that you can expect to see from Amazon. It'll tell you specifically how much better one version is over the other. They'll tell you specifically how it's improving your conversion rate. They'll tell you specifically how much more sales you're getting. This is all amazing, but what's even more amazing is the projections. So this is an example of projections that Amazon had given at the end of a test. It's the 1 year potential impact that you will see from your sales. And this is a title test done with Data Dive, low volume, okay? A very, very, very low volume brand that didn't even have any advertising turn on their listing, just went, did like, you know, really focused on their title and said, okay, if I change the title, you know, to have more, these keywords that have more potential reach for SEO, what is the likelihood that my sales are going to go up? And so Amazon is saying that you'll most likely from this test get an additional $1,500 a year. $1,500 a year is a lot for some brands that are really small sellers that are just dabbling in Amazon and just getting started. So I know that like it's really easy to kind of balk at that if you're already a seven-figure seller. But if you go back to putting yourself in the shoes of a really early stage brand that was just, they're just like a mom and pop at home and want to start selling on Amazon, this is a big deal. And best case scenario, an extra $4,000 a year off of one title test. Imagine if you had 20 products, you know? So this is the kind of impact you can have at a really tiny level just by optimizing over time. And really like this pays for anyone that you would have hired to help you do this stuff, right? This is actually an example from a high volume main image split test that we did with a client recently, where they're most likely going to see $52,000 to almost $53,000 in additional revenue from one SKU. One product, right? Across multiple variations of the products and multiple colors, but one product. Best case scenario, they're going to see over $140,000. This is one test, one main image test. That's why I say again, it's the lowest hanging fruit that every brand should be doing. Because if you, especially if you have a large portfolio of products, you should just be testing left and right. So that was step two. I'll like stop preaching about that one. Step three, how do we get the sale? So we've gotten people to find our product. We've gotten them to click on our listing. Now they're inside and they're on our product page. How do we close the deal? How do we get them to sell? So I'm going to show you the key to conversions, show and tell graphics, the framework that we are using, and A plus content versus storefronts. So the question you need to ask yourself here is, do I have pointy content that answers all the main questions that my customers have? That's the way you need to be thinking about this. Show and tell graphics are visuals that are made to sell, right? Every image that's on your listing should be doing a function. It should have a job. It should be aiding the shopper in some way, answering a question that they have. It should be really helping to solidify the deal in their mind that this is the product for them, right? So they need to identify with the product. They need to have their main questions answered. They need to remove all the barriers to buying, right? So you need to be thinking about it, not just showing a pretty lifestyle image of a flat lay. You want to be having a mobile friendly, huge copy, badges to build trust, compelling images that get people to click and engage with your content. So Amazon can see that people are actually clicking through your content, right? This is the framework that we use to actually build out our content. And actually at the end of this presentation, I have a link to our site where you can watch this presentation. You can get tutorials for all of this and you can download this template. But basically what we've identified is the main buckets of types of images that best perform for e-com brands and especially on Amazon, right? So you wanna be looking at all of your assets and say, okay, what are the things that I have to work with? What are the things that shoppers might be asking? And based around those questions, we can figure out what types of content we can create, right? So do we need to show that our product is great to use at the gym? We would wanna show it on use. In use at the gym, maybe we want to show a bar on the go in my gym bag. Maybe it's a product where we need to be showing how to assemble it. So we need an assembly image. So you want to kind of just like look at something like this and just quickly say, okay, these are the main questions that people have. So let's build these types of images. The other thing you want to be thinking about is maybe incorporating a coupon image. A lot of times coupons are not right in the customer's face. So you can get them to buy multiple products. If you can let them know that you have a buy one, get one, or you have like a, you know, a buy one, get 10% off deal, you can put that in your images. The other thing you want to be thinking about is your badges, right? These are the things that are going to build trust. Is your product gluten-free? And we work with a lot of food brands. That's why I have all of these different food categories. But you can also think about these types of things. Like, is your product, does it have an award? Does it have media mentions? Does it have any, you know, safety requirements for certain ages? You know, like those are all things that can build trust. And the other thing is that even if you haven't won an award, or even if you don't have an official certification, what are the things that your brand stands for that you can build into a little icon? Like, you know, we care about quality. We care about, you know, you can actually build your purpose statements into little badges, even if you haven't officially been granted one of these types of badges. You know, maybe your product is not in the food category. So you want to be thinking about it from that lens as well. So let's go into A+ content now. Our strategy for A+ content is really using large banners all across the board, stacking them for a landing page effect like this, and then building in 1 to 2 SEO modules like this, right? The reason for this is that, again, we're trying to stop the scroll. We're trying to make it digestible. We're trying to make it visual. We're trying to make it so that a shopper wants to stop. This is your last chance to get them to stop before they hit the reviews or leave your page, right? So you really want to focus on this area and get them to stop scrolling. And you do that with these big, huge banners that are gonna visually feel like they're hitting a landing page. It's gonna feel so custom to your brand. The other thing that that I like to say here is, like, for SEO modules, there's a module like this that has 4 images. There's another module that has 3. Those are usually we usually use one or the other. So it really depends on, are you showing maybe like 3 steps to use your product or 4 steps to use your product? That can be a great way to use the SEO module in a way that feels natural to breaking up this content, right? This very easily could have been an SEO module, this design here, but we decided to build it into the image in this case. Some more examples of A+ content. And again, you know, I believe in skipping the other modules. I think a lot of times what happens with A+ is you use too many of the Amazon modules and it ends up looking really text heavy, because then you end up defaulting to copy pasting off your website, grabbing things from Dropbox, and things just look like choppy and broken up. You can see with each one of these examples, you're really just like capturing the shopper's attention with all of these like colors. Everything looks cohesive. Even with Super Coffee, they're really like minimal brand, but you went big and bold with the copy, super mobile friendly, everything's on brand, everything's clean, and the whole thing feels like it's completely custom to them. By the way, this is one we just launched with Cartograph for Momofuku, and they ended up like right out the gate becoming like a best-selling product with this one. So this is one of my favorites to share as well. Now, what's important to talk about here with storefronts is storefronts are the only space that Amazon is giving you that has 0 ads, right? So 0 distractions for shoppers. It's usually where traffic is landing if they're doing a Google search for your type of product or something similar. You know, Amazon will target them with traffic and send them to your storefront page. You have more control over the design, over storytelling. You have some more advanced features you can do with video and more of like GIF-like effects. So you can have a lot of fun here. It's also oftentimes confused with product pages. Usually brands will come to us if they haven't sold on Amazon yet, and they'll ask us to get their storefront up and running, when really they're trying to say, can you help us set up our product pages? There are 2 very different ad strategies as well, for the most part. So what we usually recommend for early stage sellers is to focus on your product pages, meaning your listings. And then once you get that up and running, by the way, you can easily set up your own quick template for your storefront on Amazon. But once you get cash flow generating, then you want to come back and do like a full custom job on your storefront when you're ready to start driving your own external traffic to Amazon. That would be going to a storefront. That would not be going to your product pages, because you don't want to have too many visitors bounce from your product pages, and that would affect your conversion. This is just another fun testimonial of a client that was getting started right out the gate. This is possible for so many brands still. And oftentimes I hear from people that, you know, you have to be spending tens of thousands of dollars and like right out the gate. And the truth of the matter is, like, I'm still shocked by some of the brands that come to us and right out the gate, they just nailed the product. They're right on trend. They get something that everyone's looking for, and it sells, you know? And that's the beautiful thing about Amazon is that even though, yes, if you're selling a copycat product in, you know, in a high volume, super competitive niche, of course it's going to be hard to sell like that. But if you're creating a product that you believe needs to be in the world and it's answering a demand that people are craving, you know, the sky is the limit for something like that. So this is still possible even today, even when all the gurus are saying it's not possible. It absolutely is. We have clients that are doing it. So of course it doesn't happen with every client, but this is an example of another client that right out the gate improved their listings, and they had been trying to do Amazon for years. So that's my presentation. That's everything. If you want access to the longer version of this is already, I tried to shorten it for you guys to make it really condensed, but we do have a longer version. We do have tutorials, a mini course that you can get with this, and you can find it at launchreadylistings.co.
Perfect. Thank you so much. It was so interesting to listen to you. And I think you were able to actually put in a lot of different details within this short video, which isn't that short, but I'm sure it will definitely be helpful for the sellers. Daniela, I actually have a couple of questions for you as well. And hi to the dog as well. Probably will be helpful to answer my questions. So the first thing I wanted to ask, you mentioned about how important it is to cover upfront different customer questions that they may have when they are shopping around. So I wanted to ask, how do you usually, process different customer reviews or customer questions? Like what's the process like to use that data that's already on Amazon in order to craft a better Amazon listing?
That's a great one. So one, your website is going to be a treasure trove of data if you're already selling on your website. Two, even if you haven't sold on Amazon yet, there's likely other people have sold in your category. You can go and review their reviews. But specifically what I like to look at is the word clouds right above the review. So if you look at the word clouds, it'll tell you and you click on a word cloud, it'll tell you how many people in the reviews have specifically mentioned that word, right? So that's a really great way to try to understand what are the things that matter to people the most when they're buying this product, because they came back to leave a review and they specifically said, I bought this product because of blah, you know? So if they're going to say that word 50 times, 100 times, 200 times, 2000 times, that means it's really important for them. A brand that did this really well is actually Tushy. There's a lot of people that were looking for bidets. Okay. It's a bidet company. And the number one question that people were getting was, how hard it is or how easy it is to set up. And so one of the things they did in their A+ content is they made a banner that was like super easy to set up. 1, 2, 3, 4. Like it was like 1, 2, 3 and 4 is, you know, happy booty, you know, and they made it really fun and they answered the question in a big, bold way. So there was no denying it's really easy to set up. The other thing you can do, which is an alternative method that's really fun, is you can take your listing and, or even your website, and you can drop the link into a pick food test and ask people what questions they have about your product, what questions they have, they would have if they were buying this, right? And you will get so much data and you can basically gather it all up into clusters and say, okay, the number one question we got from these 50 or 100 respondents was 25 of them were wondering about this. 6 of them were wondering about this. And, you know, a handful of them were wondering about this. And then you can say, those are the top 3 things we need to make sure we visually answer in our listings, right?
Okay, very good. Thank you very much for that. So if we move now on to the main images, you brought a couple of very good examples how to make these main images a little bit stand out more than the competitors. But we also know that Amazon sellers are not photographers and they are not often creative persons. So do you have any advice how Amazon sellers could practice this, you know, when they put together a plan, what kind of main images they would like to have or other images, how they could come up with better ideas how to do it?
That's a really, really great question. Honestly, I think it comes down to like just letting yourself be a little creative. Like what we do, our process is to ideate 2 or 3 different options. So we try to really think like, what else could we be doing? So one of the things we do is go look at the search results in your category, go look at the search results in other categories, and maybe something will spark an idea, you know, and think through that list that I gave of like angles, presentation, and write a list of all the different ways that you can possibly shoot your product, right? There's really affordable options out there now for getting product photography done. If your product is a more difficult product to photograph, then I would go the render route, but make sure you're getting really top-notch renders. And you can render just about anything these days and in any type of angle and with any kind of effect. And the key is just making it feel natural and real and authentic, and that it's aiding the shopper, that it's not manipulating the buying process in any way. One of my favorite photo places is actually Suna now, because they make getting photos so easy and affordable. We use them quite a bit for our projects with clients.
Okay, very good. Okay, so are there any specific rules also regarding to the main images or other images? Let's say you mentioned using infographics that are like big no-nos, and you know that you have to avoid doing that in order to not get the red flag from Amazon.
On the main image?
Yeah, or main and other images as well.
Yeah, you know what? The thing is, on the main images, they're more specific, right? So not having any kind of icons or badges outside of your packaging, that's like a dead giveaway, right? But again, it goes back to like, what are the things the shoppers need to know about this product in order to inform them so that they can buy the right product? Beyond that, all of the other stuff that you will get flagged for, it's not that they're going to shut down your listing. They're going to suppress the listing, and they're going to tell you this image is not approved. You need to update this image or fix this image. That can happen at any time because Amazon changes the rules of the game all the time. Okay. So like, for instance, the Walmart example that I mentioned in the presentation, that used to be allowed. People used to do that on Amazon all the time. All of a sudden Amazon caught onto it and they were like, nope, no more of that. Right. So you just have to go periodically update your images and make sure that you're in compliance, right? With the kind of things that we see lately is certain verbiage on A-plus content and product images. So using language like the best in the world, or, you know, the number one, you know, or you can't use any Amazon language like bestseller, you know, you can't, you have to be careful with things like that. Also, you need to make sure as a brand owner that you are using language that is allowed based on like FDA compliance and that sort of thing. So that's the other thing that you need to do your own homework on. And then aside from that, usually what happens is you'll submit your images and Amazon will let you know, hey, you have to take out this word, you have to change this. And it's just be ready for that and make the tweaks and resubmit it.
Okay, good. So thank you again, Daniela, for joining me today. It was very interesting to listen to you and have this discussion. So before we go, could you once more give an overview of what kind of services do you offer to Amazon sellers? And also, what's the best way to reach out to you?
Sure. We do Amazon optimization for product pages. We do storefronts. So what that basically means is that we do SEO, copywriting, and graphics for brands on Amazon. You can find us at mindfulgoods.co or launchreadylistings.com. And my email is Daniela@mindfulgoods.co.
Okay, perfect. So thanks again and hope to see you soon.
Thank you.
I hope you enjoyed watching this video and learned what's the best approach to optimize your Amazon product listings for both Amazon customers and also Amazon algorithm. From the video description, you will find information and contact details about Mindful Goods if you would like to check out their website to learn more about their services. And now I would like to invite you to watch another video I recorded with Emma from Marketing with Emma about how to improve Amazon product listings by including long tail keywords.